break in a spate of home burglaries tonight, thanks to a new electronic database. Colleen Henry joins us from Greenfield. And Colleen, the database helps police reunite stolen electronics and jewelry with their owners.
Yeah, Kathy, you know, if you come to a place like the jewelry center to sell your gold or silver, your information is going to go into a public system that the police use to track stolen goods. Police say the folks here do it right and helped crack a Wauwatosa burglary case. Wauwatosa police were hunting a burglar who hit homes in this neighborhood along North Avenue in July and August when they found the stolen jewels on a database known as NEWPRS.
Over $1 million worth of recovered property.
Greenfield Detective Chuck Fletcher brought the system to southeast Wisconsin. He says it's revolutionized the way cops find fenced goods.
It's time consuming to go to this store, then over to this store. Look. I can do it in seconds. On this database.
Jewelry and electronics stores enter details about merchandise and the customers they buy it from into NEWPRS. So when police get a stolen property report, investigators can go online to see if it's been pawned and who pawned it. That's how TOSA got its break.
If you had a pendant or a bracelet, for instance, that had a pineapple on it.
In a couple of clicks on the computer.
In the last year, there are 34 items that have been sold that have a pineapple.
To determine which is yours, there are pictures. Fletcher says you can help police get back your goods by taking photos and writing down serial numbers.
If I wanted to find your stolen iPad, there's probably close to 75 iPads in the last 3 weeks.
But if you know your serial number,
I know exactly where your iPad is at.
Now, the NEWPRS database led TOSA police here to the jewelry center, which had documented the name and fingerprint of the suspect they say fenced the goods. Now, the TOSA case is still under investigation, but that NEWPRS database will be key to clinching that case. In Greenfield, Colleen Henry, WISN 12 News.
All right, thanks, Colleen. Looks